Hey everybody, Rob here for R&B Reviews, and I am going to be reviewing Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, starring Michael Cera as a 22-year-old who falls in love with the girl of his dreams, played by the attractive Mary Elizabeth Winstead. Now, this plot kind of sounds a little corny and old-fashioned, but the twist is that if they're going to date, he has to fight and defeat her 7 evil exes. Now, I wasn't sure I wanted to see the film because of Michael Cera. I had enjoyed him on Arrested Development as well as in the film Superbad, but I kind of got tired of seeing him play the same young, nervous, awkward adult character that I have seen in those comedies. But after hearing some exceptional things about this movie, I decided to give this movie a shot. Now, although I think Cera is pretty much doing the same thing he always does, he is given an opportunity to do a little bit more like fighting and acting like he is in pain, both mentally and physically. Now, I never read the source material that the film is based off of, but I felt like Scott Pilgrim was a funny, although at times repetitive, tribute to comics, graphic novels, and video games. Now, starting with a video game-like Universal logo, the film creatively features animated effects, word graphics, and split-screen effects that make that kind of resemble comic panels, like when Michael Cera is talking to his sister, played by Anna Kendrick. Now, in a way, this kind of felt like a graphic novel come to life with the quick-cut editing and sometimes abrupt scenes and, you know, shots, you know, where everything is in the center. The cast, for the most part, seems to be putting in a lot of energy and fun into their roles, including the band Cera's character is a part of, and his roommate, and a few of the exes. But the quip I have with Scott Pilgrim is that the quick-cut editing, the word graphics, and a few of the fights with the exes, I felt became formulaic after a while. And I wish Michael Cera only had to fight just a few exes. But the film had a good, entertaining opening, and when we got to the last X, the film got back to being really exciting and fun again. Some of the segments with each of the X's, some were better than others, I think. I think there is just enough here for me to give this movie a mild see-it-in-theaters verdict. It is inventive, funny, and it is a nice tribute to graphic novels, but the formula kind of got old for me from time to time. Now, I noticed this movie wasn't doing very well at the box office. I don't know if people thought it was just another romantic comedy with Michael Cera doing the same shtick, or if it was just too artsy for mainstream audiences, but I can see this movie being a cult film, and some people quoting it like, "You made me swallow my gum. Now it will remain in my digestive system for 7 years!" I'm sorry, I just love that line, so that's my review for Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. I give this movie a mild see-it-in-theaters verdict, and you guys at home know what to do. Leave your comments about whether or not you've seen it, and I look forward to reading them. Thank you very much. See you later.